Hey everybody, AbMundane here. We're back with more Braid. We finally gotten up the ladder and put all the puzzle pieces together, and we are ready to find out what the hell happens. I am ready for some answers. I hope I get them. I'm going to be very upset if I don't. Ooh, books. At a cafe on a bright plaza, most customers sit back, feeling the warmth of the sun, enjoying their cold drinks. But not Tim. He barely notices the sun, doesn't really taste his coffee. For him, this corner affords a good view of the city, and in the teeterings of the passers-by and the arc of a shop girl's hand as she displays tea to an interested gentleman, Tim hopes to see clues. Are you interested in this girl? Is that the girl? That night at the cinema, fictitious adventurers lunge implausibly across the screen. The audience here is mixed. Some are patrons of the cafe, now sitting excitedly in the plush chairs, eager for another new flavor, for distraction from the boredom of their easy lives. Other seats hold fishermen and farm workers, hoping to forget their toils and rest their hands. Okay, so they're just setting up. Okay. Tim is here too, but he is scrutinizing the gloss and the lips on the screen, measuring the angle of the plume of a distant helicopter crash. He thinks he discerns a message. When the cinema closes and most of the audience strolls down the plaza to the south, Tim goes north. Wait. The gloss on the lips of... What? What message? What? Tim, are you crazy, man? I've been asking you the whole time. You have not told me. If you're crazy, I need to know. Okay? Unreliable narrator, I need to know. Okay? Because I don't know what the hell's going on. Maybe when we're jumping on people's heads, we're killing people. I don't know. Maybe he's a mass murderer. I'm looking for answers. I'm getting more questions. It's like watching Lost. People like Tim seem to live oppositely from the other residents of the city. Tide and riptide, flowing against each other. Tim wants, like nothing else, to find the princess, to know her at last. For Tim, this would be momentous, sparking an intense light that embraces the world. A light that reveals the secrets long kept from us, that illuminates or materializes. A final palace where we can exist in peace. There's no peace in this man's mind. But how would this be perceived by the other residents of the city, in the world that flows contrariwise? The light would be intense and warm at the beginning, but then flicker down to nothing, taking the castle with it. It would be like burning down the place we've always called home, where we played so innocently as children, destroying all hope of safety forever. Oh, man. We're destroying all hope of safety going in this door, ain't we? What are these other locked doors? I guess those are like the star doors. I don't know. A rose. Or something. And everything's going backwards. This is great. How great. So we got to jump on one of their heads to get over here, I imagine. Oh, God. Okay. Oh, God. What's going on, Tim? What are you doing, man? I assume something's going to pop up here. Okay, I'm not using the walkthrough now. How do I get over here? What the hell do I do? What the fuck am I supposed to do? Well, this is awkward. Oh. So will he come back up here? Ah, damn it. Okay. The rules seem to have changed. Now we got a broken ladder. Oh, I assume we need more than one of these, eh? Oh, so, well, let's try hitting it. Let's get three of them just to be safe. Okay. Okay, we're up here. All right, we did it. Braid. Oh God, what the hell? All right. So there's the princess saying, he's saying, I've got you. Oof. Help. Oh, so he's running. She's running from him. So what the hell do I do now? Come down here. Okay. But wait. But wait a minute. Aren't things moving backwards? Oh, shit. What's going on? Okay, she's opening doors for me. I'm about to get roasted by fire! Oh, my God. Okay. Oh, God. Why is there fire? Oh, what the hell am I supposed to do there? Open it! Okay. Oh, boy. But everything's moving backwards. Yes! Okay. Oh God, what did I do? What do I do? What do I do? What did I do? What did I do? Hit the switch. Oh God. Oh God. Oh, no, no. Oh, yeah. Messed around for too long. Okay, hit the switch. Can't kill these things, so we gotta jump over them. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. Oh, the fire. Oh, the fire. Oh, the fire. Why is there fire chasing me? It's because that's time that hasn't happened yet. Come on. Come on. Come on. What's going on? Everything's going back. Oh my God. Oh, I think I know. Oh my. I'm gonna let it answer. She's asleep. Oh, now I'm walking backwards. What? Oh my God. She's asleep now. Oh my God, I'm a creepy stalker. What the hell am I supposed to do? What do I do? Can't get back up there. All right. I don't really know what to do. What is going on here? Is that it? That can't be it. Oh, maybe I have to rewind time? I don't know. Oh, I can rewind time and get back up there. Hold on. Oh, I'm rewinding time. She's trying to stop me. I knew it. I knew shit was moving backwards. Oh, my God. Tim's a creepy stalker murderer. Okay. Oh my goodness. My God. He's chasing after her. Holy shit, dude. Yeah, the fire was time that hadn't happened yet, so. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh, she closes you in. So you can't get to her. And then he's rescuing her. Wow. Help, yeah. Come down here. Yeah, they made it red at first, but now it's green.
Okay, help. I've got you. Oh my God. Do I still need to rewind? So now what? Epilogue. I do remember reading something about listening for a woman's laughter or whatever. So the green books don't say anything. I did read a little bit about this. The boy called for the girl to follow him, and he took her hand. He would protect her. They would make their way through this oppressive castle, fighting off the creatures made of smoke and doubt, escaping to a life of freedom. The boy wanted to protect the girl. He held her hand or put his arm around her shoulders in a walking embrace to help her feel supported and close to him amid the impersonal throngs of Manhattan. They turned and made their way towards the Canal Street subway station, and he picked a path through the jostling crowd. His arm weighed upon her shoulders, felt constrictive around her neck. "You're burdening me with your ridiculous needs," she said. Or she said, "You're going the wrong way and you're pulling me with you." And another time, another place, she said, "Stop yanking on my arm, you're hurting me." I knew it! I knew it! Oh, I fucking knew it! God, the bunnies, man! You fucking monster! Oh my God. He's choking her! Ah! Oh. Oh my God! Oh my fuck! Oh my God! That was the singing. Is there anywhere else? Listening for the hums. Okay. So I heard more singing. There's nothing else there? He worked his ruler and his compass. He inferred, he deduced, he scrutinized the fall of an apple, the twisting of metal orbs hanging from a thread. He was searching for the princess, and he would not stop until he found her, for he was hungry. He cut rats into pieces to examine their brains and planted tungsten posts into the skulls of water-starved monkeys. What the fuck is this guy's problem? What? What? He scrutinized the fall of an apple, the twisting of metal orbs hanging from a thread. Through these clues he would find the princess, see her face. After an especially fervent night of tinkering, he kneeled behind a bunker in the desert. He held a piece of welder's glass up to his eyes and waited. On that moment hung eternity. Time stood still. Space contracted to a pinpoint. It was as though the earth had opened and the sky split. One felt as though he had been privileged to witness the birth of the world. Someone near him said, "It worked." Someone else said, "Now we are all sons of bitches." Is there anything else? Whoa. The candy store. Everything he wanted was on the opposite side of that pane of glass. The store was decorated in bright colors, and the scents wafting out drove him crazy. He tried to rush for the door, just get closer to the glass, but he couldn't. She held him back with great strength. Why would she hold him back? How might he break free of her grasp? He considered violence! What the hell, dude? Is that where you go? Oh, she don't want me, huh? I considered violence. What? What does this do? Well, that'll crush me, won't it? Maybe if I, like, rewind while I'm on top of it? What is this? He cannot say he has understood all of this. Possibly he's more confused now than ever. Yeah, are you talking about me now? Because, yeah, sure. But all these moments he's contemplated, something has occurred. The moment feels substantial in his mind, like stones. Kneeling, reaching down towards the closest one, running his hand across it, he finds it smooth and slightly cold. He tests the stone's weight. He finds he can lift it, and the others too. He can fit them together, create a foundation, an embankment, a castle. To build a castle of appropriate size, he will need a great many stones, but what he's got now feels like an acceptable start. Oh, the women I've killed or something? What the hell? There's a cloud up here. Alright. I don't hear any other sink. So that looks like it's it. Is that it? I think so. And those represent the 8 stars you're supposed to find, but I'm not going to do that, I don't think. Oh my god. Well, how about that for you? That was Braid, ladies and gentlemen. I still don't fully understand it. I think I got some of the symbolism, the scared rabbits and stuff, and... Oh my god. I knew something was wrong with this guy. Maybe they're not talking about him? They're talking about him. Come on, they're talking about him. Come on. Except for that confused part. Then they're just definitely talking about me. Because I don't know what the hell's going on. All I know is I'm disturbed. Feels like after watching the Blair Witch Project, you know what you watched was fake? But boy, you couldn't help but feel a little bit disturbed at the end of it. It's a really interesting game. It was a really fun journey. It's really crazy. Wow. All that torture and monkey stuff. Holy crap. So I think I'm good with this game. I think if I get really curious about what the 8 stars do, I'll just look it up. Because at this point, I'm not going through all that again. That was, you know, a lot of it was, even if you know what to do, it's still execution. So that's it. That's going to be it for Braid, guys. This has been AbMundane. I'd like to thank you all for watching. As always, I love you guys and gals, if there's any of you. They're probably mostly guys, let's face it. Thank you all for watching so much. Thank you for joining me on this journey, and see you in the next one. Have a good one. So what is this one? So this one shows... All right, so he's walking in. Maybe she's sleeping with another man, or maybe this is like a kid's bedroom. Maybe they lost a son, or maybe that's his dad. I don't know. I don't get this shit, man.